How it looks to land on Mars, previewing space station spacewalks and supplies and cargo delivered for the station crew. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. Newly released high-definition videos captured by cameras onboard our Mars 2020 Perseverance rover show the final 7 miles of the spacecraft's entry, descent, and landing on Mars. The uniquely amazing views, including the look down at the separation of a protective heat shield and the upward views during deployment of the most massive parachute ever sent to another world,
are the closest you can get to landing on Mars without putting on a pressure suit.
While a microphone on the rover did not collect any usable data during the landing, after Perseverance touched down, it did pick up mechanical sounds made by the rover operating on the surface, and even a few audible seconds of a Martian breeze. Also released with the videos and audio was the first panorama of the rover's landing location taken by the two navigation cameras on its mast. These were all followed up 3 days later with the release of the rover's first complete high-definition look at its surroundings, a 360-degree panorama from its mast cam Z instrument. Perseverance will use its suite of instruments to search for signs of past microbial life, collect and leave samples of rock and soil for a future mission to bring back to Earth, and test technologies to help pave the way for future human exploration of Mars. Find out more at nasa.gov/perseverance. We previewed two International Space Station spacewalks during a February 24th briefing at our Johnson Space Center. During the first spacewalk on February 28th, our Kate Rubens and Victor Glover will prep for solar array upgrades later this year. Rubens will then go back outside on March 5th with Japan's Soichi Noguchi to vent ammonia from the station's thermal control system along with other tasks. The Northrop Grumman SS Katherine Johnson Cygnus cargo spacecraft arrived at the space station February 22nd, 2 days after launching from our Wallops flight facility. It delivered about 8,000 pounds of scientific research, crew supplies, and hardware to the station. The spacecraft is named after late NASA mathematician Katherine Johnson, one of the women featured in the book and movie Hidden Figures, who made significant technical contributions to some of NASA's earliest and most historic spaceflights. On February 26th, our NASA headquarters building in Washington, D.C. was officially named in honor of Mary W. Jackson, the agency's first African-American female engineer, who was also featured in Hidden Figures. Acting NASA Administrator Steve Jurczyk led the ceremony, joined by Jackson's family and other special guests, with the on-site attendance limited due to the ongoing coronavirus pandemic. The ceremony featured the unveiling of a building sign with Jackson's name and several video tributes, including poet Nikki Giovanni reading from her poem, Quilting the Black-Eyed Pea, which is about space and civil rights. Learn more about the contributions of Jackson, Katherine Johnson, and other NASA hidden and modern figures at nasa.gov/modern figures. Our Parker Solar Probe captured some surprising views of Venus during a close flyby in July 2020. The image shows Aphrodite Terra, the largest highland region on the Venusian surface. The team is surprised because based on the imaging device's capabilities, they only expected to see clouds, not clear down to the planet's surface. They are now trying to determine if the imager has unforeseen capabilities, which would provide new opportunities to study dust around the Sun and in the inner solar system. The mission focuses on the Sun, but it makes several passes of Venus using the planet's gravity to help it fly closer and closer to the Sun. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.